Today on BRStv, we're going to start a new series focused solely on the Neptune Apex. Hi, I'm Ryan, host of BRStv, where each week we cover a new topic related to reefing. This week we're going to start a month-long series on the Neptune Apex Aquarium Controller. This controller is probably the most popular controller and certainly our biggest seller. That's probably because it's capable of monitoring and controlling basically anything on the aquarium, and more importantly, communicating the status of your aquarium to you no matter where you are. That said, there can be a learning curve to using this product. We intend on making that a bit easier with this series. In this episode, we're going to cover, I just ordered my Neptune Apex controller. What should I do before it gets here? First thing to consider is, where do you plan on plugging this in? Since we're dealing with water, ideally you'll have an outlet with the GFCI to protect you and your home. Most homes only have GFCIs in locations near water, like kitchens, bathrooms, and sinks. Best idea is to have one installed, but you can also buy power strips with GFCIs incorporated into their design. You may also want to consider a surge protector to protect the investment in the controller and your tank. With surge protectors and GFCIs, it's important to get a good one or they're of little value, especially the GFCI. You don't want to have it get triggered accidentally and disconnect the power. In this case, I think the best way to identify a good one is price, weight, and a brand you trust. Triplite and APC products have always served me well in the past. Next, consider how you're going to connect the Apex to the internet. Pretty much every function could be entered on the display pad, but it would take a long time. It's infinitely easier to program over the internet via the browser or Apex Fusion. If your room does have a direct Ethernet connection, use it. If it doesn't, put one in if you have the ability to do so, because nothing beats a direct Ethernet connection. If you don't have that ability, the Apex can be connected via a wireless access point, game adapter, or similar product. While they don't officially support it, Neptune's suggested device is the Netgear WNCE 2001. Next, consider how you're going to mount all your new gear. You can screw them directly into the cabinet or wall. However, it's very popular to use a mounting board. These white prefab shelves work well. A board like this makes it much easier to keep everything away from water and manage the cords much easier. It also looks really sleek, which some people find valuable. Regardless, make sure to pick up some wire management tools like these self-adhesive plastic clips and black zip ties for the wires that don't need to be moved frequently. These ratcheting clips work well for cords that need to be replaced from time to time, like probe cords. Lastly, download the reference manual and begin reading. Don't try and understand every last item as you go through it. Just browse through so you get the general concepts and possibilities. If you have any questions or helpful advice for your fellow reefers, check out the comments area down below. If it's your first time with us, hit that subscribe button because we release new videos every week. See you next week with another episode of BRStv.